Welcome back again. In the previous video of this series, we covered navigation and views in Softimage. In this video, we'll take a look at basic selection and transformation. Most of the time, selection and transformation involve tools. Tools are modes that let you use the mouse to interact in the viewports. There is always exactly one tool active, whether it's a specialized tool like Add Edge or the default select tool. As with the navigation tools, the status bar shows the different functions of the left, middle, and right mouse buttons. The information updates automatically when you press modifier keys like Control and Shift. Any tool can be activated in either sticky or super mode. Sticky mode involves quickly pressing and releasing a key, such as backslash for the Add Edge tool, or selecting it from a menu. The tool sticks, meaning that it stays active until you activate a different tool or press Escape. Super mode involves pressing and holding a key while you interact in the viewport. This overrides the current tool and restores it when you release the key. You can work with one tool in sticky mode and quickly switch to others in super mode. For example, you can add an edge, orbit the camera, and then continue adding edges. Now let's look more closely at the selection tools. Selecting in the viewports involves both a selection tool and a selection filter. The tool determines the behavior and interaction in the viewport. For example, if you select polygons using the rectangle tool in the front view, you can see in the right view that polygons on the back have been selected too. However, if you use the raycast tool to draw a line across the polygons, the occluded polygons at the back are not selected. There are preferences that can modify some aspects of these behaviors. The filter determines what you can select, such as whole objects or components such as points, edges, and polygons. You must first select one or more objects before you can select any of their components. Selected objects are highlighted with a white wireframe, while components are highlighted in red. The selected object and components are shown in the Select panel, where you can also type object names and component indices directly. You can also use wildcards, such as an asterisk, to match any string. In Maya Interaction mode, the selection tool is assigned to the Q key, and the filters are assigned to the keys F8 to F12. In Softimage mode, common combinations of tool and filter are assigned to specific keys. For example, the spacebar selects objects with the rectangle tool. The T key selects points with the rectangle tool. Y selects polygons with the rectangle tool. And U selects polygons with the raycast tool. E selects edges with the rectangle tool, and I selects them with the raycast tool. For other combinations, you can specify tool and filter separately. Press Alt Spacebar to recall the last used combination of tool and filter, or click the big arrow button. Use the Shift key to add to the selection, the Control key to toggle, and the Control Shift to deselect. The easiest way to deselect everything is to click and drag on empty space. Now let's go over simple transformations. Transformations involve moving, or translating, as well as rotating and scaling. You can activate the Scale, Rotate, and Translate tools from the Transform panel on the MCP. In Softimage Interaction mode, the keyboard shortcuts are X, C, and V. In Maya mode, the shortcuts are R, E, and W. The Transform tools work with selected objects or selected components. However, using the Transform tools on components actually performs a deformation and doesn't change the object's stored kinematic values. With the Translate tool, click and drag the center of the manipulator to translate freely in the view. Click and drag on a single axis to translate in one direction only. The red, green, and blue axes correspond to X, Y, and Z respectively. Drag between two axes to translate along their common plane. In the same way, you could scale uniformly in all three axes, or scale non-uniformly along just one or two axes. The Rotate tool allows you to rotate around a single axis by dragging on one of the rings. If you are not in Add mode, you can click and drag between the rings to rotate freely. You can also click and drag on the black silhouette to rotate at a right angle to the view. The manipulation modes determine the axes and pivot used for transforming interactively. For example, global mode transforms with respect to the scene, while local mode transforms with respect to the selection. Each transform tool offers different modes, and there are different modes for objects and components. You should experiment to see which modes work best for different tasks and situations. But remember that the mode affects manipulation only and does not affect how values are stored for animation. If you need to transform elements precisely, you can type values in the Transform panel. Here, and in any other numeric box, you can enter the exact value or use relative values. For example, entering an X translation value of -1 moves an object to that location. However, entering 1 minus moves it 1 unit to the left. Entering 3 plus moves the object 3 units to the right. Similarly, you can double values by entering 2 star, or halve them by entering 2 slash. You can also enter complete formulas like 360 divided by 8. Softimage units are relative. Some content, like the pre-built characters, assume that one unit is 10 centimeters, as do the simulation forces, so you might as well use that scale. However, you can choose any other scale as long as you adjust gravity strength and other settings as required. One last thing to emphasize about tools is that their behavior is often controlled by preferences. There are a lot of preferences, so if you don't like the way something works, it's worth digging through them. You might find options that you like better. For example, you may want to set the Transform tool's Click Outside Manipulator preference to Select tool. This lets you select objects even while a Transform tool is active. And that concludes this quick introduction to Softimage. There's much more to learn, but you can now start practicing and experimenting on your own.